Wi-Fi to try and catch a bus to the next town, which we're gonna do tomorrow. But on my way here, I saw a live turtle, and I was like wondering why it was coming out now, because usually it's at night. And I looked down, and the dog had like gotten into all of the nests, and so they were all half opened. And I guess I was the first to notice it. So everybody from the restaurant came running out, and we've been running the turtles down into the ocean, trying to save the ones that are half hatched and the ones that have been hatched. But a lot of them already got killed.
Yeah, I'm just gonna film from here because there's too much wind.
Come down and release them.
Alright, we're gonna let him go.
You vlogging?
Yeah. Okay, Connor's freaking out right now because he thinks our cabina is gonna flood.
Dude, it literally is going
to. He thinks it's gonna flood. I'm gonna go check it out. I think he's just used to being on an island where they don't have rivers.
Dude, are you fucking kidding me? Go take your flashlight. Okay. Show everybody how and show them compared to what our flashlight picture was today. Go look at the. Go look. Okay. Wait, no, I wanna come in. Holy.
Dude, chill.
Okay, I'm gonna walk down to the river now. Dude, this might wash out the bridge. Usually, the water is like 4 feet lower than that. There's like full-on branches getting launched down here. Yeah, this place is like turning into a lake. But honestly, I'm not worried about our cabina. It doesn't look too bad.
I packed up all my stuff, like took all my electronics off the floor. I put my stuff in the corner over there with my drone on top. And then I slept with my bag with all my electronics on here because I was convinced that the water was going to come up into our room. And then we were going to have to evacuate. Meanwhile, Jeremy, he's still packing up right now. He was like not fazed by it, which I shouldn't have been fazed by it. But like, that's what happens when you live in Bermuda, I guess. You don't see rivers rise like that. So I was tripping out a little bit. But yeah, anyways, sorry. That was just crazy. But
okay, you love me.
But we're staying a night in Arnaldo, one of our friends, Wompy's boss?
Manager? Yeah, boss.
We're just going in their car up to his farm. Everything's just been like wet, like for the last couple of days. Like this AC is so cold that like everything is just wet. Like all the electronics and everything. Like you go outside, the camera takes forever to defog.
Yeah, this is it for TP hostels, which was really fun at first, but the weather here has just been like crazy and not fun, and the waves here have been super mushy, even though now I have a tattoo so I can't swim. But so it's kind of good timing. But yeah, we're gonna get out of here. We're gonna go stay at our friend's ranch. It is a cattle ranch, you know, go take some pictures of cows and stuff. So yeah, it's gonna be an adventure anyway.
Criminals go out.
So we just survived our second cop stop in Panama. Got searched a little.
A little bit. They searched literally the whole van.
They searched every bag and everything.
Almost did Cavendish.
Gave us pat downs and all that good stuff. They took Wompy's driver's license. I watched him like put it in his chest pocket and he just completely forgot to give it back. And we just realized that we don't have Wompy's driver's license.
And we have to go all the way back.
Yeah, so now we're driving back to go see the cops to get our license back so then we can turn around and continue.
Now they want to stop me and say I don't have a driving license.
Yeah. Did you see him do that, bro?
Yeah.
That dude literally just got Wompy's card. And I was like, what's he wiping his face with? Gets a card and pulls all the sweat down the side of his face with the card and gives it to Wompy. Did you see that, man?
That's gross. He squeegeed the sweat off his forehead with the driver's license, then wiped it on his leg and then handed it to Wompy.
So that's the second time he does it.
Is the second time he did that?
Yeah,
we made our first pit stop of the day. We're gonna fly the drones to this waterfall that we found. Right, Wompy? So we found a waterfall. You can't see it from here, but just over these dogs on chains.
Hey, buddy.
Setting up La Drona. Mash that.
Pizza and ranch. Good for the road.
Thank you. How many hours are we from Bocas?
Two and a half hours.
38 hours.
38.
We've been traveling for 18 months.
Sponsor, camera, surfer.
Hold on. Let me just line it up.
Got it.
Let's get out of here before the truck comes.
Dude! I can't run that fast.
Get in! This is the welcome to Bocas sign. It's no longer a sign.
We just crossed provinces.
This is Donald Trump's wall.
Donald Trump's wall?
Holy. Oh my god.
It's so big.
Who knocked it down?
Huge.
They knocked the wall down. Alright, fill us in on what's going on.
I have no idea.
We're speculating that a tornado just hit here recently because there's.
Tornadoes can't hit in the mountains.
I don't know, dude. I'm not a paleontologist.
You gotta plug this shit.
Oh my god, dude, look at this. You have my drone?
Yeah. Fucking my jacket on, buddy.
How can they? They're gonna think you're a tourist if you don't put it on. We're on our way to the island of Bocas del Toro.
We're having a good time right now.
We're snuggled up right now.
Dude, the boat is like sinking.
Oh yeah, so we finally made it to Bocas. We're on a water taxi.
Just like the guy in the movie.
Me?
I'm the captain
who's
now.
Now
that we're moving.
Yeah, I'll give you that car right now. Shawarma. What's that? It's like a shawarma.
Dude, welcome to Bocas, bro.
I'll see if we can make a deal with the guy for a free exchange on scuba diving and a place to stay for some photos and videos right now.
Alright, so we just got to Bocas del Toro. Yeah, so we just got to Bocas del Toro. I think we're just gonna like go look around Bocas. It's my first time in Bocas. Yeah, everything's like a dock. Everything's just like kind of trippy. You can just like get on a boat. It's weird because it reminds me of Bermuda a lot.